and welcome to my office hours. I'm Dr. Carolina Küpper-Tetzel from The Learning Scientist. And today I would like to talk a bit about how we at the University of Glasgow in psychology are delivering remote teaching to the students. I'm pretty sure that most of you, independent of educational sector, are at the moment engaging in some kind of remote teaching, hybrid teaching, or so on, given the pandemic we are in. And so I would like to share the best practice that we are using in psychology at the University of Glasgow, because it may be helpful for others as well. So the strategy we are using is one that initially was suggested by Dr. Emily Nordman, who is a colleague of mine. And then we started with that idea that she had and made it into a pretty awesome way to deliver online teaching to students. So the strategy, I call it, is to do watch parties. And so this is particularly, we use that for delivering our lectures, and it comes with two steps. So in the first step, what happens is that the teacher will record short video snippets of the core elements of that, well, of that specific lecture. So core theories, core findings. And so the teacher would do a pre-recording or a couple of pre-recordings, short pre-recordings in advance. And then in the second step, and that's the watch party step, during the actual live lecture, you watch those pre-recordings with your students. So yes, in the beginning, it's a bit awkward because you're basically watching yourself delivering the content, but it is, the benefits of this are so huge that you overcome that kind of weirdness pretty fast. So what are the advantages? So first of all, students have the pre-recordings and can watch them whenever they want. So it does not depend on any kind of internet connection speed. So they can download those pre-recordings and watch it in their own time. When doing the watch parties and watching those pre-recordings with them, that basically opens up a whole new way to actually engage with students during the live lecture. So what students tend to do, they ask a lot of questions in the chat while watching the pre-recording with you, and you have the time to actually think about those questions and provide them with answers, right? Because you don't really have to pay attention to the pre-recording. You can really focus on providing students with rich answers to their questions. You can also build in different activities during the watch party. So the watch parties are not only watching those pre-recordings, but what I do, I have a quiz in the very beginning that I give students to do. I pause my pre-recording as well during the live lecture and do an activity in between. I sometimes turn on my camera and my microphone, pause the recording, turn on the microphone and ask them a question. And it has been, I have never had so much engagement from students during a lecture. So I can also see the thought process that goes on in the students' minds as they are paying attention and watching those pre-recordings. Because really, I mean, it is a bit of a disadvantage, I would say, in a large lecture hall when you're live lecturing there, because you really don't know what is happening in their students' minds. Are they understanding what I'm just explaining, or is something unclear? But with those watch parties, you can actually really follow their thought process. So they can engage in discussion, they ask questions, they answer each other's questions questions in the chat as well. So something that's really nice to see that they're engaging in this self-regulated learning during those watch parties. So I would say this is something that came out as a very positive thing from the whole remote teaching situation. And we have received lots of applause, positive feedback from students for those watch parties. They really appreciate that they have the pre-recording for later if they want to catch up on something, but that you're watching those pre-recordings with them and allowing them to actually have a discussion and engage in activities. So maybe you want to try it out and leave a comment if that's working for your classroom. All right, bye.